Hello and welcome to Jobs and Education. This is Yumahesh Dole. Do subscribe and share my videos. Process sheet in production drawing as well as in manufacturing. Process sheet plays a key role in production process because it gives a step-by-step procedure how to complete a product. What is a process sheet? Process sheet is a set of manufacturing instructions for a specific batch, lot or runs. And it describes the operating parameters and settings for the equipment and facilities used. And also associated tooling or supplies. It contains part information, routing information, and operation detail information. You see, this process sheet is a set of manufacturing instructions. It describes operating parameters and equipment facilities and also associated tooling or supplies. It contains part information, routing information, and operation detail information. Importance of process sheet. Route sheet or process sheet is the map or the blueprint of the manufacturing process in a production unit, providing the precise route or sequence to be followed. A process sheet describes the series of actions to be performed to achieve a particular task in the manufacturing or production process. This is very important. It is to achieve a particular task in the manufacturing or production process, the series of actions. It is nothing but step-by-step procedures. What is manufacturing process sheet? The particular sheet or document is more commonly called a production process sheet. This document consists of detailed list of all steps taken into the process to manufacture a particular product, along with steps taken into avoid failures in each stage of the manufacturing process. It also details the equipment and tools to be used in each stage of the production process. With this, we can understand it is a step-by-step procedure, and also we can understand what equipment and what tools should be used in each stage. So these are the contents of process sheet. First one, identification and sequence of work arrangement. Second one, drawing of part assemblies or sub-assemblies of the product. It is nothing but part drawing, or simply we can say that production drawing. Drawing individual parts. Third one, estimated number of units to be produced. How many products we need to produce. And fourth one, machines, tools, jigs and fixtures used in the operation, their runtime, efficiency and capacity. We should form a table that machines required, tools required, jigs and fixtures required, and running time, how much time it is to take, starting time and ending time. All we need to form in a tabular form. Fifth one, operations needed on the given part. What is the operation required? Turning operation required, or drilling required, or boring required. This kind of operations we need to form a table. Sequence in which these operations are formed. We should form a sequential step-by-step procedure. Seventh one, inspection and quality assurance requirements. Finally, we need to inspect the product whether it is having any errors or not. Eighth one, packing and handling instructions during movement of components to the operation stages. This is the part drawing of stuffing box. In stuffing box, we can see these are the different parts. This is one part, this is second part, this is another part, this is. So around 5 parts are there in part drawing of stuffing box. In this, we are going to draw the process sheet for this. Here we can see this is the process sheet. In the first operation, checking the component size with the vernier calipers. We know that to check the component sizes, we need vernier calipers, screw gauges and scales. So out of this, to check this gland size, we are using vernier calipers. The second operation is fix the jaw in the chuck of 50 diameter into 9 and face the end and oval side. This is in lathe machine. Look at this. So using machine is lathe machine, and operation is fix the job in the chuck, and no tools required and no time mentioned here. Means fixing this job in the chuck of a lathe machine and 15 to 9. Where is 15 to 9? This is 50 diameter. This is 9. So 15 to 9, that should be face. Do the facing operation to that 15 to 9. And next is turning of 42 into 45. Where is 42? This is 42 and this is 45. This side and this side should be. And next is drilling of 20 and boring of 24. Drilling with drill bit and boring with boring tool. Where is the 20? This inside, this is 20 diameter. Next is drilling of 20. So that is here. inside this drilling of 20 diameter. After that, boring the same with boring tool, that is to 24 diameter. Next, chamfering the end. After that, reverse the job. One side completed. So to complete another side, we need to reverse the job. Next, face the flange surface with the facing tool. This is the flange surface. So face that flange surface with the facing tool. After that, turning 50 diameter. So this is 50 diameter. We should turn this 50 diameter. After that, bore the radius of 12. Inside this, we have radius 12. So boring 12 to both sides of that 50 diameter. After that, drilling 13 holes. This side one hole and this side another hole with 13 diameter. Two sides with a drill jig. And finally, inspect the product outside micrometer used or inside micrometer of any calipers. With these three, so checking and inspecting the component finally. This is what the explanation of process sheet. The process sheet illustrates the table of contents which are having different number of columns like serial number, machine operations, tools and gauges, time required, and different operations in sequential manner, and different machines used, and different tools and gauges used. These all are clear information about process sheet. This is the way to prepare a process sheet for every component. It is very much possible if you are a mechanical engineer, if you know different operations or processes, how to do turning operation, facing operation, drilling operation, and with that knowledge we can prepare a process sheet by looking at the figure itself. If the figure is having a hole, we can understand that hole is produced with the drilling, and if enlargement is required, we'll do that boring operation, like that facing operation, turning operation, grinding operation, so finally inspecting the element. Very important in the process sheet is maintaining the skeleton, that is providing some information above the table, that is part number, description, material and quantity and cycle time, and drawing the table with serial number, machine operations, tools and gauges and time required. This skeleton is very very important. After this, we need to understand the first and last important operation. First operation is that compulsory checking the component sizes, and final one is inspecting the element. Remaining all in between this, we can do just like that, means doing different operations on lathe machine or drilling machine or milling machine. So we will maintain different operations in sequential manner. This is what the complete information about process sheet, very important for every mechanical engineer. Thank you for watching this video. Do subscribe and share my videos of jobs and education. This is your Mahesh Dole.